of the morning.
Not a problem.
We so appreciate it. So tell us a little more about this campaign, because a lot of people, I would assume, don't know it even exists. Tell me why you felt it was needed in the first place.
Well, we were doing our All-Star Give Back, our turkey drive, and I was talking to a young student who was crying in the hallway, and she let me know that she was on her menstrual cycle. And I said that we have to address this non-academic barrier. Oftentimes, young ladies don't come to school when they have their menstrual cycle, and we have got to address this non-academic barrier to education, whether it is men supplying the needs of their needs, or is organizations partnering with us to make sure that our students have each and everything they need to be successful each and every day.
How did you come to realize that this was not just an issue for this young lady, but for several girls across that particular community?
Well, we understand that poverty is not just about money. Poverty cuts off access to people that can help you. So I called some of my friends, whether it be D.O. Hughley, Derek Coleman, Mike Epps, and some of my corporate partners, whether it be Meyer, Sam's Club, Marathon Petroleum, to join in this effort so that we can make sure our young ladies have everything they need each and every day so they can come to school and be successful students.
Absolutely. And this is the first time you guys have attempted to do this, right?
Yes, this is first, but it's going to be an annual campaign for us moving forward. We realize that the need is great, and powerless kids need powerful friends. You know, poverty is exhausting, so kids should not be inundated with adult stress. A young student should be able to come to school, get the things they need, receive that translation of education, and proceed on in their life.
Some people may look at this campaign and say, you know, it's interesting that a man is the face sort of spearheading the efforts. What would you say to that?
I would say that we as men should not be uncomfortable with something that's necessary. As a brother, as a father, as a husband, we have got to purchase these products for our loved ones and not be ashamed or embarrassed. It's not about that. What it's about is making sure that we provide ethical care and wraparound services for our young people.
Just making sure you're there for them. So tell me a little bit more about the campaign. How are you guys getting the products, and also how can people participate?
Well, we start on Tuesday. Receiving products at River Rouge High School, 1460 West Coolidge Highway. We're going to collect the products there and then distribute them. Have a resource room in the high school. Each and every high school should have a resource room for our young people, because this is a serious issue each and every day. What we're trying to say is that we want 1,000 maxi pads, 1,000 panty liners for our young people. That's our goal between now and June 20th. But we're going to make this part of our annual campaign to make sure that we do all that we can for as many as we can.
Absolutely. And how long does it last?
To June 20th. Okay. But we're going to start up again in September, because we know that every day is count day. We operate from a meritocracy. We know that each and every day we have to take care of our young people.
And you want this to one day be national, starting here in the Metro Detroit area, but hopefully national one day. Terrence Wheeler, thank you so much for your good work, and thank you for being with us this morning.
You.
We appreciate it. And we're going to take a quick break.